My name is Colin Staniford. I'm a second year medical student here at the Kirk-Corian School of Medicine at UNLV. So today we're doing the Medical Research Society Symposium. It's a gathering of all of the work and academics that our institution has done over the past year. And it's a great opportunity for the students here to put their work out there and be able to make the connections and networks that they need to further their career in medicine.
My name is Claire Victoria Ong, and I'm an M2 here at Kirk-Kirkorian School of Medicine. It's really important to be able to present your research. I think that research is not accessible to a lot of patients and community members. And that's very frustrating. Sometimes when you get a really bad diagnosis, you feel like it's the end, like with cancer, and that's just not the truth anymore. There are so many options, there's so many treatment possibilities, but you don't know because research has such a high barrier of entry. You have to have a certain education level and be able to have been exposed to certain spaces and be in even certain areas. Conferences like this and being able to share it with doctors who are actually out in practice helps them learn constantly and helps them be able to tell their patients their options.
Today I'm presenting a case study and review that works on the abilities of non-physician critical care transport personnel, the people that fly helicopters and pick you up off the freeway, to be able to do arterial lines and use them to monitor blood pressure versus just using a blood pressure cuff, which isn't always the most accurate.
Hello, I'm Ronnie Joseph. I'm one of the second years here at the Kirk-Kirkorian School of Medicine. Was basically raised at UNLV. My mom was always a single mother, and so every time she had to go to school, I was there with her, and then my siblings were there with her, and so I've always been a rebel. So today we're actually talking about one of the organizations that we had the privilege of working with over the summer, Project 150, which essentially is an organization that's dedicated to providing resources, things like hygiene supplies, clothing, school supplies to underprivileged or disadvantaged high school youth here around Las Vegas. And we're actually planning to dedicate some of our future events to spending time with the high school students there to provide them with essentially exposure events where we'll bring in different types of administration from schools, tech schools, to expose them to different STEM fields, so bring in things like nurses and physicians, engineering or electrics or HVAC units to kind of show them that there are different things that they can do in the future, and sometimes all it really takes is for them to be aware about it and then just kind of help them establish a future.
I'm Dr. Robert Wong. I'm the chair of the Department of Otolaryngology, Head and Neck Surgery at the Kirk-Kirkorian School of Medicine. We've had a great interest, great involvement by our students. Quite a few of them have been on papers and publications. I think people tend to forget how medical research innovation has affected the well-being and how we live our lives. I think this is an important event, and I hope everybody takes home the messages that we're trying to convey.
I think the school has been incredibly supportive. We've got entire faculties, entire programs. Our entire summer block is spent doing and only doing research. So we're able to connect with physicians in the community, local hospitals, and then also we have students that travel all over the country to go to different research opportunities that they've cultivated.
One of the best parts about not just medical school, but starting to get a little bit more out into the community in general, is you start to realize not necessarily how ignorant we are to the community around us, but just how unaware we are. You don't really realize that things are the way they are until you go out into the community. And it's not necessarily disheartening, but you know that there's a lot of potential for improvement. And so the cool thing about experiences like this is that you start to learn more about your community. You start to see just how prevalent issues like disadvantaged and homeless youth are, and then you can learn new ways to actually go help them out.
Through my school, I was able to have this amazing opportunity to work at the NIH this summer. So I'm presenting a project on CAR T cells and their effects on osteosarcoma. CAR T cells are the future. They're known as the living drug. It's so cool. They recently got approved for multiple myeloma, and there's just more and more studies to improve it for more cancers. It's a personalized immunotherapy, so while it is expensive, it's individualized to each patient. You see amazing outcomes. And so I think that this is something I'd want to do in the future. I wasn't considering pediatric oncology until I did this research internship. So just goes to show the opportunities that the school gave me is helping mold what I want to do.